All right, we're here, and I think we definitely want to play first with all these sigiled starfishes. Starfishies. Just so we can start scrying right away. I'm a big fan of an extra card, but think that we're going to curve out pretty nicely most of the time, regardless. So let's do it. Yeah, Spite of Mogis is definitely interesting. It's a late game card, and I have two of them. Magma Spray. The idea is just combo with Magma Spray. Magma Spray in the early game. All right, let's just get that off the table. We want that. Should I have scryed during our upkeep? No, because I was thinking maybe we would want to block that and not Magma Spray. I killed it now so that a trick couldn't be played. Okay, that's fine. Drawing a font. I'm gonna get this down though. Have a nice little body. The unfortunate thing about Sigiled Starfish is it takes us off of F6 mode. We need to have our hand on the keys now. As a potential blocker. Mastiff, okay. It's slow and it's a 2/2. And our deck's pretty good against 2/2s, so. Crystalline Nautilus. Well, it seems pretty bad with this Acro and Mastiff out. I'm not too interested in blocking, to be honest. Bottom that one. Let's do it, man. Just find our engine piece and then go off from there. Opponent doesn't seem like they're putting us our life total under much pressure. If they play a double strike, ooh. Okay, well this threatens our life total a tiny bit. Okay, upkeep. I'm gonna scry bottom. I want one block. I think we want a blocker. Lands, man. Dacromistic. Could play it. Could use Storm Chaser Chimera's ability instead. Mystic's pretty weird card. Alright, I'm just gonna play defense. We don't need much. 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 7. For how many lands we've scryed at the bottom, I feel like we're floating pretty hard, but we. Jeez. Yeah, that's gonna kill us really fast. 4. I mean, another Magma Spray. Yeah, I mean, we're gonna need to draw right now, really. We have a lot of cards we can hit. Riddle of Lightning should be one. So how are we gonna do this? We're gonna draw Riddle of Lightning. And we wanna make sure that we hit something. So I'm down to scry at least once. I'm not sure how to use this Dacromystic. Two is enough. Two's enough. We're dead to a trick, but two is enough. But I don't want another starfish, and if we only need two, we can hit on basically anything, so gonna go for the riddle here. Acheron Mastiff. Indestructible end of turn. All right, well that's gonna make things pretty difficult for us. All these cards are awesome, but the issue is that we're gonna die. Well, if it doesn't have indestructible, then we'll be fine for a turn. All these cards are very good though. I don't want to use Dacromystic. It should maybe not be in the deck. Gonna keep blockers back. Question is, what do we want to draw next turn? 3, 4, 5. We want to be able to kill this, so I think we just want to draw Riddle next turn, just to lamb blast it, and then draw Knowledge, but they're all insane. Just a matter of trying to survive at this point. Yeah, I'm ready to chump block with whatever the opponent wants me to chump block with, if possible. Pretty dead to an enchantment. Doesn't have one. Nice. I'm gonna chump with the Mystic. I don't want to feed the opponent cards when our life total's low, I feel like. And the starfishes are going to become insane. Okay. Riddle of Lightning. Bottom this one, top this one, top this one. Bang, five. And we could Spite of Mogis. We have one, two, three. We could kill it. We're not getting use out of the Scry, but whatever. It's keeping our life total high. Okay, so I mean the game's pretty much taken over at this point. We have Knowledge and Power coming up with two starfishes. Should just lock this game up in a hurry. But who knows? Big Flyer could do us in. Big Creature could do us in. Okay. Card is no problemo. Now we have our action. Boss? Yeah, this guy never attacks. It's just defense. I'm not trying to race. I might have missed in a fair amount of attacks, but like, not really caring about the opponent's life total too much. Because once we do this, the game is taken over. Okay, draw. Put on bottom. I'm just killing this now. Maybe this is wrong. Should I wait? Put on bottom. And Knowledge and Power is probably not a fun way to lose. The old Sigiled Starfish, bro. I am that guy. Bottom. Nug, nug. Top. Nug, nug. The gang. Fawn of Fortunes. This deck's awesome. The old Sigiled Starfish, Knowledge and Power, bro. Seems fine to you. Magma sprays for days. And some cards. Our hand seems, things seem okay. Don't even want to use the starfish. It feels bad to use it and not scry, but I expect a potential concession incoming. Potentially. It doesn't really seem like the best spot to be in. More starfishes. Let's do it. Okay. We're still on seven lands now. The scrying has been awesome. Yeah, we'll keep that. Pay two. Yeah, if the opponent doesn't scoop, that'd be great. Make a nice print screen for an article or something. Facebook post. Wouldn't mind an extra magma spray in my hat. Okay. Well, have I really used 22 minutes? It doesn't feel like I've been that slow. Or rather, I've used 8 minutes compared to my opponent's three. Well, that's fair. The opponent's done barely anything, and I've just been scry, scry, scry. Okay, as for sideboarding, what do you guys think of Relic of Abandon? Not a huge fan. I would play a bounce spell if possible. I'm a little scared of, but I didn't pick any. I maybe should have picked the one. I was too busy picking the hard removal, which I think is what a deck wants, although it's a bit scary because it's less certain. Well, Feast of Dreams seems like it could be pretty good. The opponent is playing enchanted creatures, but I don't want to dip into black too bad. So let's just try as is. Yeah, I'd cut the Nautilus, but I really wanted the ability to combo with Magma Spray to kill the big things.